I'm Jared Deenda, and this is Snap-on Tooltips. We're looking at the brand new PT338 Pneumatic Impact. There's still a place in the bay to get off those stubborn fasteners.
Air still has a place in the bay, and you know, this delivers a lot of power, very compact package in a 3/8 impact gun.
Yeah, it's tiny, but it still creates a large impact. So what are some of the specs on this?
Yeah, so some specs on this gun, it's 4¾-inch total length. So it's nice and small and compact, just perfect for caliper bolts, you know, especially being in the rust belt, yep. Gotta get in there and break those loose. Great for crankshaft bolts, suspension, you know, even for water pumps, alternator, anything you can really.
Those bumper brackets, right? You know, like you said, the salt belt, getting those things off, bam.
Great compact access tool. So anywhere you can think that you just can't get quite a large impact in there, this is gonna take care of it.
Got the nice variable trigger.
Yep.
So you don't hit it all
right
out of the gate. Right. Got 1, 2, 3 on the back, so fully adjustable.
Yep.
And what are we looking at spec-wise as far as foot-pounds?
Yeah, so 500 foot-pounds of operating torque, 700 foot-pounds of bolt breakaway torque. Like you said, nice large selector knob on the back of the tool so you can adjust your power level, variable speed trigger, so allows you to kind of feather it in if you want, easy forward and reverse selecting lever. So really designed for the technician to be as efficient and powerful as possible.
Looks great, but let's step inside. Feel like we're talking about an engine, and we kind of are, but cylinders, valves, I feel like we're going in the internal of a big V8.
Right, yeah, so let's just start off with the cylinder and the valve. So this is how the air is delivered to your tool. We precision machine these in Murphy, North Carolina at our manufacturing facility. And what's very cool about this is metal, obviously, and then we do a composite valve. So why we do that is a number of reasons, because we designed this to withstand in the harshest environments of shops, right? So not every shop has these great air filtration lubrication systems. So all of the, you know, air that's going through your tool, no matter how dirty it is, whether there's water or grease or contamination, you don't want these components to stick, because if it gets stuck in forward or reverse, it's because of this situation. So having a composite allows this to move freely through the life of the tool.
Yeah, because you get that friction and people would say, oh man, you're gonna create failure there with that composite piece. Quite the contrary, it's actually freeing it up and loosening up because you got dust, dander, as you say, fluids, all of that around your shop.
Exactly, and it also allows you to have that featherability. So when that valve can move and deliver the air efficiently, you can very easily feather that trigger in to deliver the power that you want.
Now let's compare. What are we looking at here? I'm seeing 6, 8, I'm seeing similar components, but there is a stark contrast.
Right, so air comes obviously into the tool, spins past this, hits the rotors, and that's how everything spins, right? So this is essentially the motor of the tool. So height-wise, not too much difference. Ours is a little bit bigger, mm-hmm. But what you really notice is the diameter of the motor. That's where the big difference is. So we also precision machine these in Murphy, North Carolina, and because we can have such tight tolerances and make that rotor bigger, we can deliver more power, more RPM to the tool.
And I'm seeing 6 of, what are these called?
Those are the vanes. So that's how essentially the motor spins up. So when air comes through, it's, you know, just like a fan, it's pushing it around, making that motor move. So we have 8, competitors will have less, or 6 in this case. And that's important because you have less opportunity to be in a stall position. So you hit the tool and it doesn't want to do anything. Sometimes you got to rotate the anvil by hand or something like that, and then boom, it'll spin.
Yeah.
When you have 8 vanes, you have less opportunity to be in a stall position.
Right.
So it's going to fire up every time.
I feel like it's teeth on a ratchet. You know, you get those fine tooth ratchets that really just are right there, ready to strike.
Correct.
All right. What do we have next?
All right. So moving a little further down to the working end of the tool, this is the anvil, obviously what comes through the tool. A couple of differences. We have a little bit larger shoulder for where the bearing surface sits, so that makes it just a little bit longer life for the tool. But where you really notice is here where the anvil and hammer meet. So there's 50% more surface area right here, and that gives you better tool life. So essentially you're giving more space for those hammers to hit, and so you have less wear on the tool. It'll last longer and deliver the power level that you expect.
Speaking of lasting longer, a lot of pneumatic impacts utilize grease. Snap-on has a signature oil bath system utilizing Redline oil.
Correct, so there are obviously moving components in here, which we just talked about, so you need to keep those things lubricated and protected. We use a Redline oil bath, mm-hmm. And so that keeps it free and clear for the duration of its life and allows that tool to operate at peak efficiency, whereas grease, you know, it gums up, it wears out, and that's when you need to repair it.
Awesome, you've seen the internals, you see this stubby right here, the PT338, great option in pneumatic impact.